Hello all. I request all of you to come little forward and please come little closer. Good evening and a warm welcome to all of you for the inauguration of this exhibition, One Brush, an exhibition of paintings by Kazuaki Tanahashi at the National Gallery of Modern Art, Bengaluru, in collaboration with Kabir Project, Shri School of Art, Design and Technology. As the distinguished guests for this evening program, we have with us Shri Jyoti Sahi, artist, theologian, and educator. Jyoti Sahi is the most important Catholic Christian artist alive today and has been called the theologian with the brush. In addition to writing three books on art, theology, and culture, his prodigious oeuvre includes painting, carving, woodblock printing, and architecture. Having also designed numerous chapels and churches, he lives with his wife Jane and four of their five adult children in and around Selvapura village near Bangalore, where he founded an art ashram in 1972, and Jane runs an experimental school. Jyoti has also taught at Shri School of Art, Design and Technology since 1979. We also have with us Srimati Shabnam Veermani from Kabir Project, artist of this exhibition, Mr. Kazuaki Tanahashi, Srimati Satyabhama Badrinath, director, NGMA Bengaluru. We welcome you all to this inaugural ceremony. A warm welcome to all of you once again. I now request the dignitaries to commence this evening's program by lighting the lamp and cutting the ribbon. I request all the dignitaries to come closer to the lamp. The lighting of the lamp. Art and technology. I request the dignitaries to come near the ribbon, and I request the chief guest to open the ribbon. Thank you.
which is, I suppose, a very rare, I mean, it's a rare thing that we are experiencing at the NGMA. And I suppose this is my first experience of seeing an artist work. So it's going to be very fascinating as far as I'm concerned. And I'm sure it's going to be the same for all of you here who are assembled. And this is something, this type of an exhibition is something which is a little different from the usual ones, wherein, you know, the tradition of calligraphy, especially the East Asian calligraphy, is being brought forth to the art lovers of this city. And what is more interesting, of course, is that it is a profound confluence of the art of East Asian calligraphy and the Zen philosophy. And it's a, you know, a common ground which the artist is able to integrate and practice his artworks. And now, without taking much time of yours, I once again extend a very warm welcome to the artist and the project director, Ms. Shabnam Veeramani, who was from the Kabir project, who has taken a lot of interest, really worked very hard towards making this exhibition a success. And last of all, to Mr. Jyoti Sahi, who readily accepted to be the chief guest of this exhibition. He's, as already introduced, a great artist, theologian, and an educator, all combined. And I suppose it's something which is very rare in today's world. And I welcome you, sir. And I also welcome all the art lovers who have come here for this inaugural function. Thank you.
Association, I now request Satyabhama ma'am to present bouquet to the chief guest, Mr. Jyoti Sahi. I request ma'am to give bouquet to Srimati Shabnam Veeramani. I request ma'am to give a bouquet to the artist, Mr. Kazuaki. I also request ma'am to give a bouquet to Srimati Geeta Narayanan. Geeta ma'am. I now request Shabnam Ji to give her address.
Thank you very much. I'm really happy on behalf of Geeta, director of Srishti, and the Kabir project. We are truly delighted to be able to host Kaz in Bangalore for 2 weeks. So once again, welcome Kaz to Bangalore in India. I said in the Alliance event that audiences in Bangalore are reasonably familiar with some of the events Kabir Project has organized in the past, and they have been live performances of a different kind, mostly to do with music. And like the director of NGMA said, this is another kind of live performance, which is quite unique, and it's to do with art. And our work at the Kabir Project has been at the intersection of art, performance, poetry, politics, and spirituality. And for us, it's deeply meaningful to extend our boundaries and create dialogues with traditions that Kaz represents, which include all these: art, performance, poetry, politics, and spirituality. So welcome again, Kaz. I'm so happy we are here today. Needless to say, the discovering Kaz was through our friend and advisor, Linda Hess, who happens to be in her visit to India this time, Mrs. Kaz. So it's through Linda that we discovered Kaz's wonderful works, and we are very happy to be able to share them with Bangalore audiences today.
Thank you, ma'am. I request Mr. Kazuaki to say a few words.
Good evening. It's so wonderful to see you. Thank you for coming. It's my great honor to be hosted by National Gallery of Modern Art, Bangalore, and I'm very happy to be in this beautiful city in the great country of India. My wife kind of brought me here, so I'd like to thank my wife, Dr. Linda Hess, an expert in Kabir study, and I have to read my note, and then. The director of NGMA. Dr. Satya Obama, thank you very much. And very able staff of this gallery, including Darshan Kumar, who is kind of doing a ceremony, I guess. And then Lingaraju M, who was very helpful installing these paintings. And many people were so kind, the staff. And I really appreciate all their help. And Srusti Institute of Art, Design and Technology has been greatly supportive of this project. So I greatly appreciate the Institute, especially Director Geeta Narayan, and then thank you so much. And many of your staff members who are so kind and very helpful. And the Kabir Project at the Srusti Institute, headed by Shabnam Irumani, who has been the main kind of driving force for this project. Also, her staff members, Vipul Riki, Smriti Chanchani, who's made a great signs and invitations and the photographs. So I deeply appreciate your work, Smriti. Sampol, and now, Jyoti Sahi, distinguished artist. I visited his website and it was so inspiring. It was wonderful. And I also saw his film, Kabir and Child's Universe. Very, very inspiring. And you talk about the educational crisis, and I agree with you completely. And we have volunteer students from Shri Institute, Yashvi Vasundara. Yes, you have been very helpful. Ishita Agawal, thank you so much. And then thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir. I now request Mr. Jyoti Sahi to give his inaugural address.
It's been a great honor to me to have this opportunity to speak on this occasion of the opening of this exhibition. I have been involved with Srishti since more or less it began in 1997, and I have known Shabnam for the last 12 years and been very interested and influenced by the Kabir Project. So this exhibition and its relationship with peace has been something that has been very interesting and important to me. Shabnam a few days ago, a couple of days ago, when there was a introduction of some of the works of Kazuaki, said that it was a form of performance art, in the sense that she also is very much involved with performance. Watching the process of painting in a sort of public forum like we had, it struck me that it had very close relationship with ritual, in the sense that it was, it reminded me of the way in which even the Dalai Lama and other Buddhists, especially the Mahayana tradition, of making a mandala and of as not just as art, but as creating a universe, creating or sustaining the universe. And so this whole idea of a circle, which is a mandala, is something which is small, which is contained within this room, but is also in a way a image of the whole of creation. So in that sense, this Zen tradition of creating the circle is itself a ritual. I know that Tagore first visited Japan in 1916. It was a time of war and a lot of tension. He was just wanting to start his University of Vishwa Bharati, a universal place where all cultures could come together. He made many talks in Japan against nationalism. But he also was very interested in the kind of folk culture which came out of pottery, the different crafts and so on, which in fact he brought back to Shantiniketan. I think that what personally has interested me in the Shri School of Art and Design is this folk tradition of India, where we have what is known as dhuli chitra, making designs on the ground. This is in Bengal, it is called alpana, but in the south of India, it is known as kolam or rangoli, or we are all familiar with that, where again, a mandala form is created in front of the door or in the home or at the time of a dance. This form is, especially in the kolam tradition, is a line which is continuous. The person who makes the line begins and ends after the pattern where the line started, and it never stops. So it is in a sense a one-stroke gesture. And in fact, what interested me looking at the work of Kazuaki, you must forgive my memory, Kazuaki, was that it was linked in a kind of a dance, a sort of movement, a gesture. And I think that is what is so important in the calligraphic tradition of Japan and also of China, that it comes from a gesture. It's a kind of mudra. So it is a movement as well as making a form. And that is why the image is related also to the word, is related to the poem, haiku, the link of word and image comes through this movement of gesture, which is also a form of writing. So I would conclude, I think, with a short poem, you could say, which is in one of the writings of Kazuaki, where he says, again, again, and over again, picturing in my heart, erasing and picturing. So this poem reminded me again of what happens with the Coulomb pattern, which is drawn and then erased after it is drawn, as a part of the, you could say, the process of life, which is created and then dies and passes.
Performance on one stroke painting, followed by a walkthrough by the artist, Mr. Kazuaki. I request all of you to assemble at the cafe space once we finish the live performance, walkthrough, and viewing of the exhibition for the high tea. There's one announcement. In conjunction with the exhibition, on 23rd December at 6 p.m., we have Zen Art and Beginning in the World, visual presentation by Mr. Kazuaki, on stage conversation with philosopher Sundar Saruki for future exhibition and events. Kindly follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Thank you all. Have a warm evening.
I like to do some writings of ideographs. Ideographs were created in ancient China, and this is the system where one symbol represents one word. So there are many words, so there are many, many symbols. This is the only writing system in the world that is one symbol to one word system. All other writing systems, including your scripts, are all phonetics. So one or two or three symbols represent one sound. For example, this means heaven. So I'd like to show you the very early form of heaven. A person is spreading arms and legs. That means big. You can see this is a big head. So big head is the sky. or heaven. In ancient times, these symbols were carved on wood and then stone and animal bones. So it was hard to carve a disc. So the disc was replaced by a line. So that means kind of sky or heaven, early form. And then when the brush was invented, Japanese, it is called kanji, but I would call it an ideograph. That means, you know, the symbol that has ideas, symbol of ideas. So you can see some brush movement, the same character, but this is more like a formal script, which is a base for like types for like books and newspapers. And then with the brush, I did a little bit more continuously. We call it semi-cursive script. Because there is heaven, I like to try earth, heaven and earth. My artist's name, One Mountain Person. One Mountain Person. In Japanese, Ichi San Jin. So I signed also my name, Kaz, K-A-Z, Kaz. Some of the paintings have my signature in alphabet. There and there. Water. I'd like to do the five elements that came from ancient India. And in Buddhism also, five elements are important. Earth, water, fire, air, and space. I think if I do space, it'll be easier. Thank you. So the space can be also, originally it means sky, or emptiness, or boundlessness. And then air can be, in Chinese, it's also wind. These ideographs were created in China and then introduced to Korea, Japan, and Vietnam. So it's been a common writing system in most part of East Asia. And you can see some of these works have ideographs. Also in Japanese, phonetics like alphabets are used. So some of my poems were written Japanese alphabet. Fire. Thank you. We'll start the walk from outside the entrance, number one.
Photography is prohibited in the gallery space. I request all of you to cooperate and don't take any photographs. And request all of you to please put your phones on silent mode till we finish the walk. Thank you.
kind of interesting, you know, in this case, quiet is a kind of drone part, and the brass is sort of a background. And when we change, we create actually a body which has a space, but also we also create an unpainted part together. At the same time, we create a space. So, what was the question?
The question was, when I
so, this is just geometric forms. And it's on Venetian red, and then gold. Venetian red goes best with gold. So in the European tradition, it sort of enhances gold. This is golden paint. Just a little bit real gold in it, but not so much, just symbolic amount. And circle, please come in. This is circle, triangle, and square. And he didn't explain what it means. But I think it's toilet. But it's, and then circle means personal, wisdom beyond wisdom. Wisdom beyond wisdom. I call it all inclusive, wisdom of oneness. And then I call this samadhi breakthrough. And then square integrity. So it's a precept, keeping precept, being ethical. So I call it, let us call it point. And this is the wall is the face, actually. Mountain. When this is a Mahayana interpretation of Shakyamuni Buddha's enlightenment, 2,500 years in present day Bodhgaya. So Mahayana idea is that when the Buddha saw the morning star after doing some practice, Chinese or Japanese, East Asian calligraphers don't use colors. Usually black, sometimes gold, but in the United States, so I'm sort of out of the box. And then, some people may be complaining, but I don't hear anything. Safely in the US. Thanks to the 10th century court poet. And I think she was the greatest female poet of the land. I loved her, and so Linda and I named our first child, our daughter, Karuna Izumi, S. Tanahashi. By her. In Japanese, it says kuraki yori, kuraki means zoi, kubeshi. You may from far away, moon on the mountain of wings. So it's a very dark poet. And she was in despair. During that time, very dark, kind of. Life is going into the dark. This is a poem of snow. So I wrote it on some kind of white. And using white paint. So actually most people can. So in the Jewish cosmology there are 1 billion worlds. And said it was such a So that's the idea. So, and this is from one of my peace poems. Peace is crying. When every bone we drop, peace is crying. Every battle we win, peace is crying. I was writing during the Second Gulf War, the war with Iraq. But before that, I was saying that peace is crying. This is called Non-Violence is the Answer. So, war is not the answer. That is our answer. Water and trees and fire.
Space.
Space. Space. Yes, I was done first. And then this one. So that we don't have, even if the sun brush was wet with paint, still, it's over it. And then can paint it, they clean the brush and wipe off the paint. And then I think the third one was the red one, and then this one, and then finally this one. And this is a haiku poem, which is a combination of these three symbols are ideographic, and this is ideographic. The rest is phonetics.